Hello again and welcome to Ndudu by Fafa.
Hope you are enjoying all the recipes so far, and if you haven't clicked that subscribe button, you need to subscribe now. Thank you.
Hello everyone and welcome to Ndudu by Fafa. My name is Fafa Gilbert and today on the menu
it's beautiful Angwa Mo with the Ndudu twist. This is a flavor zone. Like my infusion in my big crash is in Yagro. Like my konya kwanukokokodanduduyanude. This is called pleasure zone in your mouth, really. That sounds so touchy. Anyway, so to start off, I'm actually just adding some coconut oil to my saucepan because I'm going to be frying the rice, you know. But to do so, I need to infuse the oil with flavors. So coconut oil, I find, works really well with this. And to that, I'm actually going to be adding my diced onions. Now, when I'm making my angwamu, I like it to have this sort of golden blush color, which I like. So I'm actually going to fry these onions till it starts to brown. So yes, maybe some would go like, oh, jene na she en she. It's deliberate. And it also gives it that smoky flavor anyway. So now that it's brown, and I'm actually then adding my whole chilies to it. Now, if you don't actually have the kpakpushit or these type of chilies, you can actually use habanero chili. And because habanero chili is too spicy, it's best to use a quarter of it because you just need that residual heat to the background. You don't want it too spicy. But these chilies are not that spicy, so that's why it works. Now, if you actually watch my salted beef recipe, yes, you would actually find out how I actually made my salted beef here. So I'm actually just adding about 100 grams of the salted beef to my onion and chili mixture. And yet again, I'm going to fry it so it browns and also it lends its flavor to the oil. So infusion, not a hair, is taking place again. Now, if you've actually watched my previous video on how to cook the perfect coconut rice, you know that I do wash my rice till it runs clear and then actually add boiling water to it and I leave it to steam. So you can do this when you actually start frying your onions and your chili. So by the time that you're ready to add it to it, it's perfect. So you're parboiling this rice, which means that you're quickening the time. Now it's best to actually use long grain rice, or in my case, I actually use basmati rice for this because you know, it's just perfect. When you use the short grain ones, it actually has more starch content, and it means say we need to say tips. I'm not even describing the thing properly. Anyway, moving on. So once you've actually done that, you've soaked your rice, you then add your rice to your oil, your spiced oil mixture. And you need to fry the oil in this mixture for about 3 to 4 minutes. Now, the purpose of actually frying the rice in the spicy oil is to allow the rice to also absorb the flavors. One thing I always talk about when you're cooking, each step, you need to intensify the flavor at each step of the way. So at this point, it's perfect, and I'm just going to be using just enough water. You don't need too much water because at this point, I've parboiled the rice. So the water should actually just be about 1 centimeter above the rice. So I'm mixing everything together now until it's well combined. Now, also because you're using the salted beef, you have to be careful as to the amount of salt you actually add to this mixture, because the last thing you want is a salty rice. I've been a victim to that and it's not nice. Now, I've also preferred to use basmati rice, but you can use long grain rice because it has less starch content. So yes, that's why I've actually chosen to use the basmati rice in this instance. So now I'm actually going to bring this to the bowl. Do you think I should infuse some more flavors? So I'm now going to be adding some dry rosemary. Now, dry rosemary has this distinctive taste that works perfectly with this dish. I mean, traditionally, when we're making this dish in Ghana, we do not add the rosemary. But of course, this is a creative channel. And this is Ndudu by Fafa. And this is me infusing things. So you know me and my infusions. So you've got to allow me. So yeah, so I've just added my rosemary and I've just mixed everything till it's well combined. Now I need this to actually boil. At this point, cover your saucepan with its lid just to actually allow the rice to boil. So immediately it starts to boil, what I'm actually going to do is reduce the heat to its lowest setting. And then I'm actually going to be using a foil. You can use a greaseproof paper if you do have access to that. And I'm going to cover this. Now the process of doing this is to trap in the steam, because you've just added just about enough water, so it would form that perfect steam that is required to cook this rice. And that's it. You trap it, you seal all the edges, you cover it with its lid. And so far as it's on the lower setting, you can enjoy yourself. I mean, alternatively, if you want to bake it, you can bake it at 180 degrees. You can put it in the oven and you need to bake it for about 20 minutes and that'd be fine. But I think if you actually just do it this way, it's great anyway. Now, alternatively, if you're using a coal pot, you have to take some of the coal out, or you can actually use the metal ring that is actually placed on top of the coal pot so that it's not a direct heat. So it's an indirect heat that would cook your rice. You see, cooking rice on a coal pot, I love it because it actually gives it that smokiness. Like there's this taste, yeah, just say, the flavor, the language is not even coming out. You wonder cook. So yes, look at that. This is not any other food. Ndudu, anya yala. Eyi mako, mako, mako. Madam, daka. You can just see the flavor and you see that beautiful blush color I'm talking about. Oh, eh, filmza. Now, I served this with actually a grilled T-bone steak, which I infused with suya. That's the next recipe coming up, and it was incredible. Now, this is an inspiring recipe to actually include in your Christmas dishes, because it's like, you know, what else can you do? Yeah, Angwa Mo. Of course, you have to have your jollof, but Angwa Mo is also another level. You've got that saltiness from the beef. You've got that beautiful coconut flavor. You've got that smokiness coming from the onion and sweetness as well. Just say, rosemary is also doing it. Yeah, but come on. Hey, we should have a ba. Adriana, a ba. Nienelebe. Banwa yo. Of course. Do you think I was going to leave it like that? Oh, no, I had to add my shenanigans. So I've just sprinkled it with some Greek basil and spring onions, you know, and I'll tell you what, it's just perfect and ready. I hope you've actually enjoyed this episode and you are inspired to try the recipe. I do love hearing from you guys. Like the video, leave a comment with the feedback as to how you tried the recipe, if it did work for you. And I also need your help to actually push this channel from where it is to 20,000 members by the end of the year. I think that's incredible, wouldn't it? Oh, I'd love that. Yes, absolutely. Now, you will find the transcript of this recipe, including the measurements and ingredients, on my blog in ndudubaifafa.blogspot.com. So do check it out. I'm also on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram as ndudubaifafa. So do pass by and say hi. Until next time, take care of you. Be you, be nice, be beautiful, and be kind. Love you. Bye-bye.